Alrighty, so on this one, what I had is I had 2 to the x power. So I thought the easiest way would be is if I could make 8 using a base of 2. Well, 2 to the third power is 8. So now I have 2 to the x equals 2 to the third power. The only way that that could be true is if both exponents had the same value. So I ended up with x equals 3. Same thing here. I had 3 to the x power. So the nicest way to solve this would be if I could write 27 to 3 as 3 to some power. Well, 3 to the third power is 27. So the only way that 3x could equal 3 to the third, or 3 to the x equals 3 to the third, is if x equaled 3. And that's what I got. 2 to the x. Well, the only way, the easiest way to solve that would be if I could make 4 as 2 to some power. So 2 to the second power is 4. Well, if 2 to the x equals 2 to the second, that must mean that x equals 2. This one got a little bit trickier, but it was okay. So now I have negative 2 to the x power. So what I needed to do is I needed to try to write negative 8 as negative 2 to some power. And I got negative 2 to the third power. So the only way that negative 2 to the x power could be equal to negative 2 to the third power would be if x equaled 3. So x would equal 3. Number 5 here. So Jane's talking about buying fruit salad and potato salad for some picnic. The cost of the fruit salad is $2 a pound. The potato salad is $4 a pound. So altogether, she needs 6 pounds of salad, and yet she doesn't want to spend more than $20. So it says, write and graph a system of linear equations, also list 2 possible combinations of salad Jane can buy. So we're talking about cost, $4 a pound, $2 a pound. They tell us here X is our fruit salad, Y is our potato salad. So fruit salad was $2 a pound, potato salad $4 a pound. Okay, X is the number of pounds of fruit salad, Y number of pounds of potato salad. And it has to be less than $20. So I did this by intercepts. So when X is 0, that would go away. It would leave me 4Y equals 20. Y would be 5. Then I let Y be 0. So when Y is 0, this would go away. That would give me 20X equals 20, or 2X equals 20. So X would be 10. Then I went ahead and I graphed those 2 points on the line. Plugged in 0, 0. Is 0 plus 0 less than 20? It is. So I drew my arrows knowing that my area had to be underneath this line here. Then, over here, I did the same thing by intercepts. I let x be 0. When x is 0, y was 6. Then over here, I let y be 0. So when y is 0, x is 6. Then I put my point here at 0, 6, and this point here at 6, 0, and I drew my line. Then I tested the point 0, 0. Is 0 greater than 6? That's false. So I had to shade on the other side of the line. So I drew an arrow on this side of the line. Now what I needed to do is I needed to find the area below the black line and above the red line. And that ended up to be this little region right here. So any other point inside this little region would make the equation true. Now in number 6, I came down and I tried to find my y-intercept. My y-intercept was 5, followed it down, and I found out my slope was negative 1.